helping Lawrence Davey turn his turd of a restaurant,
first thing I've spotted in dog shit,
into a tourist hotspot.
Look at you.
Hi.
This week, I'm back to find his ego knows no bounds.
Two or three of these now would be nice.
Or are you opening another Le Pain?
I'd like to, yeah.
Fuck me.
That's some ambition when you're serving charcoal for dessert.
We could be doing better.
He's stubborn as a mule.
It's not black.
You're fucking defensive and you're fucking ego.
I'm going to defend my food.
He stands me up and the sun's gone to his head.
A packet of crisps and a bag of fruit gums. Lawrence, are you fucking mad?
Why not?
Fucking hell.
Costa del Sol, Spain. For the first time, I'm abroad on a special mission to rescue a failing British-run restaurant. During the summer months, thousands of Brits will invade the Mediterranean coastline and spend their hard-earned cash. And to cater for the masses, more and more British restaurants are opening on the Costa.
Scampi and chips, sausage and chips, fish and chips, barbecue chicken. Lovely.
Get it right here, and you could be sitting on a gold mine.
How many portions of chips would you serve
Per
week, roughly?
We probably do in excess of 100 portions a day, so 700-800 a week.
How are the chips?
Very good.
Yeah? What would you do if I banned chips from here?
I would not be too happy at all.
Would you not come?
Probably not.
This is English, totally.
Yes.
And it's good English.
Is there anything on the Costa that doesn't come with chips?
One more steak garnish, please, and a lamb shank. I'll get that.
One restaurant owner who thought he'd spotted a gap in the market is 26-year-old Brit Lawrence Davey. 18 months ago, he borrowed £40,000 from his dad and opened a Parra de Burriana 200 metres from the beach in the coastal resort of Nerja.
This restaurant has great potential to be very successful and very popular. It's in a great location, but I've been doing it for a year and a half now and I haven't seen any success whatsoever.
Armed with his catering degree and a few years managing nightclubs and restaurants, Lawrence designed a Mediterranean menu with a twist to lure the Brits away from their egg and chips.
My particular favourite, king prawns in garlic and ginger and chilli, served with our signature chocolate sauce on the side. Not very popular. It kind of proves the adventurous side of my customers.
With the prawns in chocolate sauce failing to win round the Brits, he lost 22 grand in his first year.
I don't know whether I went about it the wrong way or whether people don't want it or aren't ready for it, I don't know.
Since then, he's broadened his menu to a massive 72 dishes, cooking everything from Chinese chicken to Turkish kebabs.
I've even served chicken nuggets and chips to an adult, and I absolutely hate it. I really hate it.
But with takings down on last year, he'll be lucky to survive the summer, let alone the winter. I'm in Spain to stop La Parra from going under.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi, very well, how are you?
Very well, Lawrence.
Yes, it is.
Good to see you.
And you?
When did it start going really quiet? When did it?
We suddenly snapped about September last year. It suddenly just went, you know, the light, as if the light was switched off. And it just died. Ever since then, we've been losing money.
What did you know about restaurants before you opened it?
I did my degree, did my internship in America.
No, in terms of, that's training, in terms
sure,
of...
Sure, sure. It was a nightclub in Cheltenham, and then became restaurant manager of a big restaurant in London.
Uh-huh.
And that's when I really said, I'm doing it, I'm doing really well, I'm succeeding in everything, you know, what I'm doing, why
do
can't I do it for myself? They need it, they need me in Nerja. Uh-huh. They really need me to do great stuff.
Yeah. And now you're 26?
Yep.
And in the fucking shit?
Yep.
How bad in the shit?
I'm €102,000 in debt.
€102,000?
Yeah. So, 70 grand, yeah.
So the noose is really on your neck?
I've either got to make it here or go back to London and pay back my father.
Fuck. Signature dishes are, what would you say?
Signature dishes, we do a great prawns dish with uh-huh. chocolate sauce, which I've done from day one.
Prawns with chocolate sauce?
Prawns with chocolate sauce, yeah.
So start and dessert at the same time? Well, fuck me, that sounds different.
Right, let's see what a former nightclub manager has to offer the Brits abroad.
Huge menu, extraordinary menu, and then different themes. Flamenco, burger night, kebab menu. Chinese chicken or pork, confused. So what the fuck's going on?
If I'd wanted a Chinese, I would have gone to one. But I'm in Spain, Let's hope Lawrence's signature dish of prawns in chocolate sauce gives me the flavour of the Med.
Cool, dear. I mean, it's worse than a chocolate sauce. It's hot, over-spicy chili chocolate sauce. Well, that's just stupid arrogance, really. Trying to match something that's never going to go.
If that's how Lawrence serves up fresh local prawns, then I wonder what he's got in store for my fillet steak kebab.
Well, he's gone for the kebab, which is our wow factor dish, when, you know, it comes out on the hook, so I think he gets to see that bit of what we do.
Fuck me. Is that how they're always served? Oh, Jesus. Fuck me. It's the kind of thing you imagine Jordan eating with her fucking hands behind her back. Is someone taking the piss? How can you expect something like that and that to be cooked at the same time? A fillet steak kebab may not sound that exciting, but should taste delicious. And that, in terms of presentation, looks like a pile of shit.
If I thought my kebab was overcooked, that's nothing compared to what's happening to my creme catalana.
What's all that smoke coming out of the kitchen? Is everything okay
there? The dessert,
yes. From my dessert?
It's just when they burn the top.
Burn the top?
Well, not burn the top.
No, looks like they burnt the kitchen down. Fuck me. Well, it's certainly burnt. It looks like a fucking ice hockey puck. Look at it. Comes with an appointment at the dentist tomorrow morning at 9:30. Fuck me. It's liquid, and it's ruined. So when you're sat with all these fresh ingredients on your doorstep, and the climate they've got, the simpler it is, the better it's gonna be. Unfortunately, they've got more complicated and tried to be clever and completely lost the fucking plot.
The first rule for running a restaurant in Spain is don't ruin good produce with fancy gimmicks. Good food will always sell itself. Lawrence's novelty dishes may have been designed to turn heads, but all it's done for me is turn my stomach.
Prawns? The flavour of the prawns was extraordinary. Fresh, vibrant. Why do you want to fuck around and put chocolate sauce on there?
Because I don't want to be boring. I want to be exciting.
I thought it was fucking hideous. Didn't work. But then I came to this fucking schlong, that kebab. Have you actually ever sat at a table and watched six customers with this fucking donkey's dick swinging in front of their face? It's hilarious.
Well, that is, you know, it's a talking point. It's a wow factor.
That's a wow factor.
Yeah.
It's a fillet steak.
Yeah.
It was tough as old boots.
Sure.
I don't know.
Well,
you know, before you start fucking mouthing up, let me just show you. A cube that big and a cube that big are not going to cook the same time. Oh, fuck me, here we go. Can I just finish the sentence first, Sinbad, and then you can fucking come back on me in a minute? That out there was embarrassing. So it's painful. If it's painful for me, and you're 102,000 fucking euros in the shit, fuck knows how you sleep at night.
I don't. You know, I feel so shit about the whole thing. But deep down, I really wanted to work, and I want my dream to come true.
You're in Spain. You don't have to be that fucking quirky to be good. I'll see you in the morning.
I've certainly got my work cut out. I get the feeling nightclub boy isn't going to give up his novelty dishes without a fight.
Prawns and chocolate sauce. Fuck me.
All this year I'm off to sunny Spain. Viva España.
For the first time, I'm in Spain on a mission to turn around a failing British-run restaurant. Former nightclub and restaurant manager, Lawrence Davey, came to Nerhach to conquer the Costa. He thought his novelty dishes of swinging kebabs and prawns and chocolate sauce would win over the egg and chips loving Brits. But the Brits aren't biting, and after sampling his food, I can see why.
Lawrence thought he was going to come over to Spain and take it by storm. He opened up at 24 years of age, using his dad's fucking money. He thought his balls were bigger than the mountains, and he thought he was going to bring a Mediterranean twist with a difference. He's got all the gimmicks, and he thinks by being simple, it's too plain for Spain. But you'd never think he's 102,000 euros in fucking debt.
OK, two chicken satay, three petitos moronos, one prawn cocktail.
Tonight is my chance to see how La Parra copes with a full service. With Lawrence cooking the a la carte dishes alone in the kitchen, his sous chef Norm is grilling the kebabs and steaks on the terrace barbecue.
This goes up and down, so I can higher or lower it according to cooking temperatures.
Fucking hell, so it's a very modern, updated barbecue.
Yes, it's more like a torture rack for foods.
a torture rack for food, he's not joking.
Love is a burning thing.
Now, in my book, I think that's well done now.
Suffering on top of the grill are 10 chicken kebabs that have yet to be ordered.
Why'd you cook them so early on?
Well, I've only just done them.
Are they cooked?
Yeah.
So not really barbecued, are they? They're almost like poached.
Well, I sealed them off, poached them, and then finished them on the barbecue again.
Okay. Kebabs grilled, poached, left sitting in the heat. They're hardly fresh off the barbecue. But according to Norm, there's plenty of life left in them yet.
I usually use them tomorrow for one day.
Are you out your fucking mind?
I know, I was letting myself go there, but I've told you the truth.
Don't even serve those to the stray cats after service tonight, let alone the fucking customers. Fucking hell.
Rule number two for running a restaurant in Spain. Tourists might have holiday insurance, but that doesn't mean you can give them Spanish tummy. When cooking on a barbecue, don't take risks. And as night falls, the world of La Parra becomes even darker. Norm looks like he's preparing for a wake. And after seeing his kebabs, I wouldn't be surprised.
It's like we're at fucking midnight mass here, you know that?
I know.
What's that?
It's the dynamo torch, isn't it? Right, let's see what's going on here, eh?
Cooking by clockwork torch, it doesn't get any more Mickey Mouse than this.
Well done, Philip's sake.
Sorry?
Well done, Philip.
Well done, Philip.
Yeah.
We haven't got that, sweetheart, no.
I ordered a fillet steak about an hour ago and it hasn't turned up yet. I'm just bloody starving, hungry.
The food may not be Spanish, but there's certainly something mañana about manager Alex's service.
I've been sat there over an hour for the main course. He's cooking it and the plates are in there.
Yeah.
This fragmented fucking service is horrendous, you know that? Mm. Is it normal for customers to wait this long?
Right, so, yeah. I can't go any quicker than I'm going. I'm going as quick as I possibly can. It's not as if I'm not trying.
He can try as hard as he likes, but no chef can cook 72 different dishes on his own. To keep up with his orders, Lawrence has thrown everything onto his plancha grill.
It doesn't get any lazier than that. He's depending on that plancha grill to cook everything, from fucking dorad to kebabs to chateaubriand and then this fucking lazy med veg. That is the most disgusting way I've ever seen fucking good ingredients bastardised. He may as well open a fucking greasy spoon and serve egg and chips, because that's fucking disgusting.
It's day three, and the hard work starts here. If I'm to stand any chance of getting the Parra out of the shit, this place needs a fresh start.
Forks on the floor, glass everywhere, cigarettes, chips, dog shit, fuck me.
I've seen some unsavoury things in my time.
Alex, 2 seconds.
But dog shit in the dining area is unforgivable.
First thing I've spotted is dog shit. That's not good enough. Are you happy with that?
No, I'm not happy.
No.
That's disgusting.
Rule number three. Running a restaurant in Spain isn't a holiday.
There's a laid-back attitude, the fact that we're in Spain, so we can afford to be semi-casual because we're dealing with tourists. No, are we fucked? We're running a restaurant. And thinking that it's good to work in a dirty kitchen or a dirty restaurant with dog shit in, forget it.
If dog shit goes unnoticed, then it's no surprise the kitchen is dripping in grease.
Your fryers are used a lot.
Yeah.
There you go. That's what you're cooking out of, yeah?
Right.
Every time putting fresh oil in there is making fuck all difference. That's slodge.
With the restaurant having a much-needed deep clean, there's something else I want to clear up. Last February, Lawrence put on a Valentine's dinner for the local Donkey Sanctuary charity. 100 British expats paid £30 a head for a fundraising meal. Rumour has it, Lawrence made a complete arse of it.
How bad did it go? I mean, was it
It was a complete fuck-up. It was absolute disaster.
In what way?
The food was overcooked, dry, tasteless.
What was the menu?
We did the chicken liver parfait, which wasn't made until the morning, so I had no time to set. A chicken dish wrapped in Serrano ham, baked in the oven. And the chicken was so dry, it was like cardboard.
Did you give it to them on the house?
No.
You charged them?
Yep.
Fucking hell, no wonder they haven't been back.
Rule number four. when you're running a restaurant in Spain, don't piss off the locals. When the tourists have gone home, the local expats account for 80% of your take-ins in the winter months. Without them, a British restaurant in Spain can't survive.
Hola. A las burbas, por favor. Gracias.
I'm heading into hostile territory to make peace with the natives.
I'm off to the local donkey sanctuary, and hopefully, after meeting them, I don't want to see if there's any chance they actually come back and give the restaurant one more fucking chance. Gracias.
All I know about donkeys is they're stubborn. This isn't going to be easy.
I'm fascinated to get to the bottom of what actually happened on that fundraising dinner in terms of big event.
I mean, not to be funny, it was a sort of meal that you're all waiting the next day to have a very nasty trip into the toilet.
What was the menu?
Chicken stuffed with banana, supposed to be served with asparagus. Mm. Yes.
Banana and asparagus.
It was supposed to be his signature dish.
Not another one with a fucking twist on there. This became cancerous, didn't it? Because it spread like wildfire across the town.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's a small town.
Actually, he's quite arrogant about the whole thing.
Yeah.
If he thinks he can survive in a small town like this with that attitude, he's got another thing coming.
Have you been back since?
No.
Charging a local charity for a bad meal smacks of unbelievable arrogance. Lawrence might have come to Spain to offer the Brits something different, but so far, all he's given them is pretentious novelty food. I'm going to give him a taste of his own medicine.
Have a taste of that. Smell first, maybe, and a little taste.
First up, a chocolate and prawn smoothie based on Lawrence's signature dish.
What's that taste of, Lawrence?
Chocolate. Yeah, you smell chocolate to begin with, and then it tastes like cookies.
Cookies? Mm. Taste that one again.
No, thanks. I think it's fucking horrible.
Okay.
Next, a chicken and banana smoothie based on the dish he served at the Donkey Sanctuary dinner.
There's a texture in there which is quite stringy.
Stringy?
It says stringy texture.
It's a banana and string.
Oh, man.
Banana and something horrible in it again.
Mine falls off. The first one is fucking prawns and chocolate. Could you taste the prawn there?
Well, I knew there was something in there that was not very nice.
You didn't get it?
No.
What I'm trying to say, if you've got the best of prawns, let them fucking taste of prawn. Don't let them taste of prawn and chocolate. This is the most painful smoothie, because it's the chicken and banana, and it's the dish that managed to piss off the locals at the Donkey Sanctuary fucking charitable event. What the fuck were you thinking about putting banana and chicken together? Tell me so I can help you.
Okay. It was just, you know, using like a South American kind of influences in roasting chicken.
You didn't fucking tell me the truth about the banana.
No.
It's not just mixing prawns with chocolate and chicken with banana that's the problem. It's the other 70 dishes on Lawrence's huge menu.
Sit down.
I want to replace it with a dozen dishes that he can cook easily to stop the tourists waiting hours for their dinner.
Have you come to terms with, you know, trying to restrict the menu?
Every time I try to think about it, I think of the people that have asked for this, those particular items and why I shouldn't take them off. I do get some return customers, so I must be doing something right.
But where are these fuckers then? Because I've been here for 3 nights on the trot and I don't see the fucking return business. You give me the impression, in such a short period of time of knowing you, that I've got a young man that's playing with his dad's money, trying to fucking run a restaurant. That's the impression I get.
Well, I think that's wrong, because I believe in what I'm doing is right. If I didn't, I wouldn't be doing it.
I couldn't do this fucking menu on my own, with 72 dishes on there.
Lawrence is refusing to reduce his huge menu, but it's the only way he'll ever cope with a busy restaurant. It's time to prove my point. For tonight's service, I've devised a 3-course Mediterranean menu that will fly out the kitchen and get customers served quickly. A gazpacho soup, barbecued chicken with a warm potato salad, and a roasted caramelized peach.
What's the twist?
There isn't a twist.
It's all fucking local. That's it? There's no twist there?
Yep.
Tonight, customers will order from Lawrence's a la carte menu, but when he falls behind, he'll switch to mine, and that will show him how quick he can serve customers.
I just want him to have that emergency menu, yeah, at the forefront of his mind, set his ego apart, get that back in London.
and for him to concentrate on sort of accomplishing a fully booked service with no complaints.
Got an order for chocolate prawns? He said, you know, earlier, no one wants to buy chocolate prawns, he thinks it's shit, a stupid idea. First order that came in, chocolate prawns and carrot soup. So,
It's 9 o'clock, and the orders from Lawrence's huge menu of 72 dishes are now flooding in. But it's already starting to go wrong.
Medium.
Yes.
Yeah. Look, it's raw, it's not pink, it's raw. It's raw. It's red raw.
All I want you to do is just cook a fucking kebab properly.
Well, that's still live one, isn't it?
Yeah, please. Right, you in control. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, that. I'm not going to taste that yet, but it looks burnt.
Lawrence needs to push the button now and replace his menu with my menu if he's to avoid a repeat of last night's fiasco.
You want to push the button?
No.
No, seriously.
No.
Seriously,
yet.
Yeah? You sure?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Hey, this has nothing to do with your bollocks and the size of your cock, is it?
No.
Lawrence's reluctance to use my emergency menu means it's the customers who suffer.
And if I'm dead honest with you, the lamb is... Everyone's saying the lamb's bone dry. It's appalling, really. Really is appalling.
Yep. Yeah.
What happened to that one there?
Not hot enough for them.
That's not cooked, that's raw.
But the complaint was that it's cold.
Yeah, it's cold because it's what? It's raw. But why?
Yeah.
When meals start coming back, Lawrence finally cracks.
Right, you all right?
Yeah.
You are, yes?
Yeah, I've called your menu away.
You've called it away?
Yeah.
It's all done. Okay. All you have to do is call it away.
Okay.
Hey, Norman's just got to put the fucking chicken on the barbecue, nothing more, yes? Thank you for pushing the fucking button.
Pushing out my emergency menu should have been idiot-proof, but they've left it too late. And in the hands of Dumb and Dumber, it descends into farce.
This is like putting 25 minutes ago.
Yeah, and I'm still time late because I've had to send food out. I can't stop, start,
okay.
Stop, start. I'm doing my next order, which is two pork kebabs and a chicken kebab.
No, I just asked you.
Yeah, I'm going to brush
Norm.
I'm looking for the cloth, Lawrence.
Okay. Oh, come on, man. But the time I need to pull your finger out now is right now, you know that, eh?
No.
Yeah?
I've got two pork kebabs to make here.
But why are we serving pork kebab when we've got the emergency menu on?
I don't know. Ask the waiter.
There's little point in asking restaurant manager Alex.
You guys on top of stuff, how are your tables? Do I need to go to any tables at all?
He's so confused as to who's ordered what, he's now serving food to tables with no one on them.
They should be here, but they're not here.
This place right now is the biggest shithole in Spain. It's fucking embarrassing. Costa del Shithole at its best.
It's the worst meal we've ever had.
Well, it's 11:45 now. We got here at 9:30. We just finished the main course, so it has been a long wait.
With customers worn out from waiting, meals been sent back, and now refunds been handed out. Surely even Lawrence can see that by sticking to his stupid menu, he's only got himself to blame.
I'm speechless, so I don't know what to say. Let's get to the crux. Lawrence?
I mean, Norman was put under far too much pressure tonight. You know, your menu made him plate up his own plates and do the starters and the cold soups out there on the barbie, and he couldn't manage, slowed him down too much.
You're telling me that my menu fucked him up on the grill?
He couldn't deal with it.
Couldn't deal with what? Putting a fucking bowl of soup out that was already made for him?
Well, that was, it was shown.
When are you guys going to stop fucking around with excuses? When's one of you going to step forward with a pair of bollocks and give me some fucking honesty? Because I don't know where you were, because that was fucking shocking. Let me tell you something. You made a fucking good decision. You pushed the button. Whether you like it or not, it was too fucking late. An hour and a half late. So whose fucking fault was it now? Chef, I'm fucking out of here. Fuck yourself. Mm.
Riley wanted me to be honest. I told him what I thought. Yeah, maybe I should have led with his whole menu. But that's hindsight. And in hindsight, I should never even done this fucking project.
It's day five, and there's storm clouds over La Parra. I've never felt as bad about a restaurant as I did last night, and when I walked out, I wasn't sure I'd be coming back.
Pissing out.
But just when I thought things couldn't get any worse, there was a break-in, and nearly £4,000 were stolen from the premises overnight.
Morning.
Gordon.
Yeah, fine. First of all, sorry to hear about the news.
Fucking hell. It's not good.
It's not good at all. How much was it?
€5,500.
€5,500?
Hey. She's not happy either.
Well, she's not much of a fucking guard dog, is she? Hey, psst. And where's the safe?
It's not so much a safe, but a cash tin in a filing cabinet.
They've left the small notes. They just took the big ones.
Why would you leave £5,500 in there?
The most important rule for any restaurant owner anywhere in the world is always put your takings in the bank.
Jesus Christ. I've got to think long and hard whether I can actually continue without that money. And now that may be the clincher that, you know, I won't be able to make it.
It's not just a failing restaurant I'm dealing with, but an owner about to book his flight home. Yes, we had if ever there was a time for Lawrence to realise that I'm here to help, it's now.
You know, it's your pride that you've got to stop fucking worrying about. Because how fucking proud are you going to feel at fucking Malaga Airport with your bags? What are you going to do? I don't go through that kind of bullshit to fucking help turn a restaurant around. I can't do it without you.
I've only one more chance to get through to Lawrence and get him listening to me. You wouldn't go into a bull ring without taking clear instruction from someone who knows what they're talking about.
Lawrence.
Hola,
Rafael.
Hola. Rafael.
Listen to this man for the next 5 minutes because he's going to show you some very, very crucial moves.
You? If Lawrence continues to ignore my advice, he may lose his restaurant. But if he ignores Matador Rafael, he could lose his balls.
Big fucking test for Lawrence now. He's got to stand on his own 2 feet and show me, as the Spanish would say, your cojones. Show me you've got a pair of bollocks and fucking use them.
Have you got your cojones?
Sí.
Yeah?
No problema.
Where?
Where? Currently tucked up inside. Fucking hell.
Where's your cojones?
Oh, it's a fucking... It's just a shitstorm. Don't think Spanish bulls like me very much. What am I doing? Oh, fucking hell. That's not a good sign.
One thing he doesn't need now is stubbornness. Hola. Here we go. Get off your ass. Come on, get up.
I'm not doing that.
Come on, get out of here! Come on!
Hey. With Lawrence carefully listening to Raphael's expert advice, he starts to get the hang of it.
I won one!
You're right.
Rule number six. Running a restaurant in Spain is a risky business. It pays to listen to some expert advice.
Fucking scary, no?
Yeah.
How do you feel?
I feel like your point's been proven in a very big way.
You have a big pair of cojones. Now just fucking use them.
Yeah.
Well done. Get some water.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Now I've got Lawrence listening, I need to get him cooking like a proper chef. Every night, Lawrence cooks everything on this plancha grill to save time. As a result, it all tastes the same. Fishy meat and meaty veg. I'm going to show Lawrence that in the time it takes him to cook a whole sea bream on his grill, he could fillet it, fry it, and make a simple Mediterranean sauce.
What I'm trying to do, Lawrence, is make your life fucking easier. You know that?
Yeah.
And whilst I'm still waiting for yours, I've just got an orange, a lemon, a pink grapefruit, fresh basil. Are you cooked yet?
Almost.
Out and on. Now, I'm not trying to be some jumped-up, fucking smarmy-ass little fucker. I'm just trying to explain you're busting your bollocks the wrong way round. I know which one you can do 10 times quicker and 1,000 times better. Don't be scared to use a pan, OK?
He's drilled into me my pride and, my arrogance has really shown through and I've been a bit of an arse about it and a bit stubborn. And, I'm really now excited that he's here. I really want to learn and get this place moving.
The penny might have dropped, but now I've only got 2 days to put things right.
Out with the old, in with the new. Fucking bin them, We're short of coal tonight.
With Lawrence finally letting go of his huge menu, it's time for a new beginning. In its place, I've created a small Mediterranean menu using local produce. 5 starters including figs and serrano ham, and watermelon with feta cheese. And 6 mains including a pan-fried sea bream and a barbecued chicken on a warm potato salad.
Actually, cooking properly feels absolutely fantastic at last. Limited menu, fresh ingredients, absolutely amazing.
The menu will offer Brits something authentic, fresh, and above all, quick to prepare. And in reducing 72 dishes to 15, service couldn't be any simpler for restaurant manager Alex.
Menus. Yeah. So, OK, what about this table here? HRD booking.
I've just taken the order now.
OK, good. OK, let's go. Yeah. The menu's simpler, a lot easier. We can do volume now. Now we've got a chance to put the fucking thing right.
It's my final night, and it's the relaunch of La Parra's new menu. OK. I've only got one shot at this, and I can't afford any mistakes.
Cooked ratatouille. Changing you tonight. Yeah, you're coming off that barbecue. Yeah, I want you connected to the owner as a sous chef. Okay. That's my decision, and I'm sticking to it.
I'm putting sous chef Norm in the kitchen, prepping cold starters.
Ready.
And pot washer Tom will take his place on the barbecue.
It's 2 chicken plates.
It's a gamble, but I'm confident Tom will send the meat out cooked.
Well, all you have to do is take the chicken off the barbecue and put it onto the plate and send it, yeah?
Sure.
Good.
Here you go, sir.
This evening isn't just about launching a new menu. It's about Lawrence regaining his reputation with the British expat community. 6 months ago, he hosted a fundraising dinner for the local donkey sanctuary. Serving frozen starters and chicken stuffed with banana, it was a fiasco. Tonight, I convinced them to come back.
It's very nerve-wracking having them here because I know how much I upset them last time and I know how much distaste they have for the restaurant in general.
Right, donkey sanctuary just set down, yes?
Yep, OK, we're on their starters now.
Treat that table like a time bomb.
The starters arrived for the donkey sanctuary. But just when I thought it was all going to plan, Alex has forgotten to serve the wine.
How could we put the starters down without serving the wine? Of all tables. Come on.
At 9 o'clock, the restaurant's full. But bizarrely, there's a backlog of people waiting for tables. It's Alex's responsibility to get them seated, but he's flapping around like a headless chicken.
What's going on with this fucking table that's waiting the bar for so long? Table 6.
Table 6, yeah. I double-booked it, you see, at the start of the night, and I had to tell them that, we need to have the table back.
Who did you tell we needed the table back? The customer?
The customer, yeah.
What about the fucking kitchen? They need to know first, because they've got to cook it.
Yeah.
So they move your arse, huh?
Alex has simply got greedy in thinking they can turn tables around in an hour. As a result, people are turning up for the reservations, but have nowhere to sit. And in the kitchen, Lawrence is now struggling with a backlog of orders.
The dog central table.
On top of all that, Alex has now gone into meltdown.
Alex, get a grip. Alex, you can do it, Alex.
Do it, all right?
I know.
You can fucking do it.
All right?
We're waiting on you.
I know you're waiting on me, and I really appreciate this.
This is fucking critical. Fucking
hell. Go.
Come on, Alex, please.
We waited for 40 minutes for a starter, then sat with dirty plates for 45 minutes. And then we were asked to leave the table because the next lot of guests arrived.
Five plates, yeah, one, two, three, four, five. Five.
Although under pressure, Lawrence is at least coping with my reduced menu.
Yep. Yeah. You got three serrano, three watermelon, yep. Yeah. Finish us off in a minute, as soon as I get these out.
I can only be grateful that Lawrence got the Donkey Sanctuary main courses out before the shit hit the fan.
The food is actually very good. I think everybody's quite pleased with the food.
If he can come up with this sort of deal, yes, we'll be back again.
Good. But the service leaves quite a little bit to be desired, I think. A lot more work on the service.
It's the end of the evening, and Lawrence's cooking has been a success. But Alex's double booking madness has let everyone down.
We're so close, Alex. So close. You can do better.
I know I can do better.
You can do better.
I know I can do better.
Turn around and tell him that. He's paying your salary. Fucking tough nine. A real tough nine. 87 covers and it was a struggle. And the service was fucking pretty dismal. However, the Donkey Sanctuary have confirmed they're going to come back. That speaks volumes. That means the local community are now back on their side. And quite frankly, you can't ask for a more crucial time for them to support it because we're just about to come out of the summer season and enter the fucking winter. And without their support, they won't get through the winter.
In 6 days, I've finally seen a change at La Parra. But once I've gone, Lawrence has only 4 weeks until the end of the season to make the money that will help him survive the winter.
Remember, do not cut corners. Don't make a fucking ass of yourself. That's gone.
Yeah.
That is fucking gone. Goodbye.
Okay.
Bye. Bye.
I only hope La Parra's doors will still be open when I return.
Spain, La Parra was a bloody nightmare.
I left them a Mediterranean menu that should have seen them through the winter. But if anyone could mess it up, it was Lawrence and Alex.
Now I'm back, I'm dying to see if the fucking place is still open. La Parra is open and it's busy. Fuck me. Look at you.
How are you? You all right?
Hi, buddy. You well?
Yeah, very well. Yeah, very
good
well.
To see you.
Yeah. And you?
How's it been?
It's been very, very good. We're on average about 50% up, sometimes double each
really?
Month. Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
What a turnaround. Lawrence was losing £22,000 a year, but with the expats propping up their winter trade, he's pulled in a 33 grand profit.
They're all the positives. What's the negatives?
Don't know. I haven't expanded yet.
Is that what's on the cards?
Hope so, yeah.
Already?
Yeah. Two or three of these now would be nice.
That's great news, providing this one's working perfectly. Yeah, definitely.
A second restaurant. This one has a lot to live up to. Lawrence's new menu has no stupid twists. But I'm in Spain, so I'm dying for something native.
There doesn't seem to be much Spanish influence going on. Right. Good to see you.
You too, mate.
When I left, the menu was bursting with local vibrant flavours. But now I'm faced with Italian pasta and that old Spanish classic, bread and butter pudding.
Bread and butter pudding.
Bread and butter pudding, nice one.
Is that a...
Oh, if we get so many compliments on that.
Really?
It's delicious, yeah.
Alex has a new team in place for the summer season. Norm and Tom have moved on, and the service has improved.
Thank you, my dad.
But the food hasn't.
These kind of things, you'd expect absolutely perfect. And they're not. Pasta is like mush, almost like a puree. I wouldn't even serve it to a baby. Not good. Greasy, way overcooked, and fucking tasteless.
If these boys want to open another restaurant, they're having a laugh. Speciality of the house is still cremated desserts.
Burnt bread and butter pudding on the bottom. You think a year down the line, we could be doing better. Where is he? Kitchen.
Right.
I came really thinking the place was going to be closed. Arrive, it's open, busy, and I'm so fucking happy. But unfortunately, not very happy with the food.
Right.
I looked at the menu, I thought, fuck, there's nothing authentic, nothing Spanish. Pasta was absolutely shocking, cooked to fuck. Why was it so mush?
Truthfully now.
If I cook it al dente, I get more sent back.
You get it sent back?
Most of my customers like it overcooked.
Lawrence, come on, fucking hell. I'm not going to fucking listen to you telling me that overcooked pasta is what they want in Spain. Come on. Why, and it's perfect that it's here, why is my bread and butter pudding fucking black on the bottom? You're not going to tell me that that's what they want as well now, surely.
You're lying.
It's not black.
You're fucking defensive and your fucking ego's been
dented. I'm going to defend my food. You think I'm just going to sit here and go, yeah, it's all burnt, sorry, shit. I'm not going to do that.
I'm being honest.
Right, and I'm being honest. There's a customer in here who says it's the best bread and butter you ever had.
Mine was full of burnt fucking raisins. Just have a little taste of that.
Okay, no.
No, I love the way you... No, I want you to taste it. You taste that. I'll eat it with you.
Okay.
So, right.
Lawrence still can't admit when he's wrong, and I can't stomach bullshit. He soon confesses that while the evenings are busy, lunchtime trade is dead.
We should be busy for lunch.
We should be, yeah. We've tried our hardest. Past 2 months, we've been open every lunchtime, and it just hasn't worked. It hasn't kicked off at all. Everyone wants to be on the beach.
You've got ambitions of opening other restaurants, yeah. But 5 years, fully booked every fucking day before I open my second restaurant, to make sure that we're fucking solid, customers are happy, and we're doing it right.
This is so frustrating. Rule 7 of running a restaurant is don't get ahead of yourself. Yep. Only when restaurant one is perfect can a second be considered. I've only got a few hours tomorrow till I fly home, so we'll have to work fast.
It'd be nice to get everybody here for 9 o'clock.
11:30.
9 o'clock. Right. Fucking hell. Unbelievable. Good night, my darling. Good night, princess.
I love ambition. Absolutely fucking love it. But in this game, you've got to fucking walk before you can run and... Think about it. A chain of La Parra's? Fuck me.
I'm back at La Parra on the Costa del Sol. Owner Lawrence wants to open a second restaurant, but he's not perfected his first one yet. His lunchtime trade is dead. I've only got a few hours till my plane leaves, so I'm going to speak to the Brits myself and find out what do they really want to eat when in sunny Spain.
When you come to Spain, yeah, what do you enjoy eating the most?
Spanish food, sardines.
Yeah,
barbecued on the beach there.
Fish and chicken.
Prawns.
Penne pasta?
Not really. No. Spanish food.
That's why you look so fit and healthy. Have a great holiday.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies.
It's clear what the Brits want. A real flavour of Spain. And I'm dying to get stuck in.
Unfucking believable. 9 o'clock in the morning. Busy day today, and not one member of staff here. Only in fucking Spain.
Good afternoon.
Morning.
Finally. I asked them to be here at 9. It's nearer 10.
Late?
I'm on time.
On time?
Spanish.
I was Spanish.
Yeah.
Bollock. Absolutely bollock.
Lunchtime trade was never going to pick up by replacing my Spanish-infused menu with dishes that just aren't native. I can't wait to hear their other ideas.
Perhaps do takeaway lunches.
A packet of crisps and a bag of fruit gums. You're having a fucking laugh, aren't you? Fruit gums.
Hi, mate.
Lawrence, are you fucking mad?
Why not?
Fucking hell.
No.
Fruit gums? No. Mushy pasta? I have to show Lawrence he's got the wrong idea about what his customers want. I'm challenging Lawrence to a cook-off on the beach in front of all the tourists. Pasta versus paella, with only the most popular dish going on the lunchtime menu.
You got your speedos.
It will drum up good publicity for La Parra and remind Lawrence what the Brits are hungry for. His tasteless penne or my authentic Spanish paella, a recipe he needs to learn.
First thing, what would you put in there?
Onions, garlic.
Chorizo.
Chorizo.
Yeah? Gives that really nice golden colour.
Onions?
With the onions, garlic and chicken in, the smoky aroma will have every mouth on the beach watering. In go red peppers, saffron and Spanish sherry vinegar.
Gives that sort of depth, brings out the flavour of the chicken, so just round the outside. So, rice in. Nice.
In go local prawns and stock. Add fresh squid, clams and let the flavours of Spain fuse together.
Wow. That looks and smells fantastic, thank you. Let's have a little taste. See that nice, dark, rich colour? Fucking delicious. Sorry.
Yep.
Don't swear in front of the girls.
The paella's nearly ready. Lawrence just needs to fry up his ropey penne.
Penne pasta, cooked al dente.
Good.
Excellent.
And we'll see which dish the tourists prefer.
Are you hungry?
Yeah!
Bloody hell. Christ almighty.
Hello, my darling.
Sorry. Take some pasta as well, yes?
As I thought, the Brits are going loco for proper Spanish paella.
Best paella we've had.
And Lawrence's dreary pasta is coming in second.
We can have this in Leeds.
They're in Spain, so paella is preference, isn't it?
Lawrence has realised what his customers want, and now we can push for some bookings.
Would you walk 200 metres to get a paella like that?
Yes, definitely.
Good. I'll see you for lunch tomorrow.
Okay.
Now you're in Spain. Would you come for a bowl of pasta or would you come for a paella?
Paella.
Why would you come for pasta?
Because we get that in Italy.
Exactly. So there's the next restaurant you can open up in Italy. Yes?
Pasta there.
At the ranch, with 30 bookings for a late lunch, the flavour of Spain is back on the menu.
Another paella?
But I have a little forfeit up my sleeve for Lawrence.
Lawrence and I had a competition today on the beach. Sadly, Lawrence lost. And part of losing the challenge is that he's now going to come up here and have a little dance. Come here, come here, come here! Ladies, please. Now.
That you're an arsehole, Gordon. You're an absolute arsehole.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lawrence. Woo!
Now that Lawrence has regained that flavour of Spain, he can start thinking about his second restaurant. The first one has to be perfect. He has the perfect paella, so sky's the limit.
Come on, 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 come on,